Well, it's time to head out and check for mullet. Let's head over to the beach. Now, most of the bait is along the beach early in the morning, 6:30, 7 o'clock, something like that. And then they start traveling. They're podded up right around the edge of the beach for safety, and then they start moving south once the sun comes up. So once the cold fronts start coming down from the northeast, the mullet come down and they form pods right on the beach for safety at night. Then they start moving once the sun comes up. You need to get over here earlier, and it's about 9:30, but we should be able to see if there's any fish being caught on the south jetty or if there's any mullet along the beach. If not, maybe we'll talk about waves. So the wave formations are different in the winter and the summer, and that's what makes for the sandbars right off the beach. So I know you're probably saying, what's he doing here? Thought we were going to go check on the mullet run. Well, we are, but I have to stop by my dad's house for a couple of reasons. Turn off the lights, turn on the AC, bring in the mail, and wait for my wife to bring me my wallet because I forgot it at home. Okay, so my wife's over here at the bagel shop. I'm going to go pick up my wallet and then let's head over to the beach and see what's going on. Well, we'll talk about waves a little more over at the beach. But one of the things that occurs with the change in the waves is that sandbars are created, and the waves go out between the sandbars. They're called runoffs. And my cousin that I used to fish over here with used to fish those. They're called runouts, not runoffs. And one time, Florida Sportsman found him over here and did a whole cover story on him. So he's been on the cover of Florida Sportsman. While I'm sitting at the light, let me talk to you about the tarpon that are in the sharks that are in the bait fish. Everybody thinks it must be really cool to catch one of these big fish, but I'll tell you, all they do is they run straight out. They run straight out and strip all the line off your reel, and that's the end of it. I've hooked these tarpon before by mistake, and they just strip all the line out, and it goes pow, and you're done. Unless you haven't have another spool of line around that you feel like putting on your reel, you're done fishing for the day. So you want to try not to, I mean, I don't know how you try not to catch a tarpon or a shark, but they're usually on the outside pushing these bait fish in. Now, this is all going to change here very shortly because the bluefish are going to show up. And the bluefish just destroy the baits, whether it's live or artificial, and you have almost like no chance of catching a snook. Once the bluefish come, that's the end of the snook fishing. So we have this mask mandate in Palm Beach County. You can't go in anywhere without a mask. So I've got a few of them right here in the car. I heard from somebody on the internet, when you walk out of the house, you're supposed to get keys, wallet, phone, and now it's keys, wallet, phone, mask, hand sanitizer. Any event, I got my wallet now, and even though it's pretty easy, keys, wallet, phone, I forget the wallet. I get talking to my wife about opening the gate and closing the gate, putting the dogs away and whatever else is going on, and forget what I'm doing. So.
there were no snook here, but those were some finger mullet. So that's a good sign that maybe the mullet run has begun. So let's head down the beach and see if we can see any, spot any pods of mullet. Out here the water is white. I know they had some big waves, I guess from one of the storms, but let's go down here and check and see. We might see get lucky. Well, this is really crazy. I don't know if you can see this behind me, but the water is absolutely white. I told you in my video the other day that snook like it when it's milky like this, but I can't see any mullet. So it's good for the snook and bad for me trying to make a video for you. So I think we're gonna wrap this up, head back over to my dad's house. So my buddy Tom that I told, I post the daily results on YouTube channel. Today is Friday, no mullet. If you've enjoyed this video though, you might consider subscribing so you don't miss other ones, and give me a thumbs up down below. I really appreciate it. Till the next video, have a great day.